कुछ
रिकॉर्डिंग
डिले है क्या?
में थोड़ा थोड़ा डिले है आज। मैंने रिकॉर्डिंग वैसे चालू कर दी है,
हाँ लैग है भाई, प्रॉपर लैग है।
आज आज प्रॉपर लैग है, तो थोड़ा 1-2 सेकंड देना है एक दूसरे की बात को थोड़ा फ्लो होने के लिए। वैसे मैंने व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप तक चालू नहीं किया, तो उसकी भी अपॉलॉजी मांगनी पड़ेगी, पब्लिक अपॉलॉजी। सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग नाउ। दिस इज बाय द वे, आई थिंक दिस इज ऑल्सो मोमेंटस ओकेजन बिकॉज वी हैव रीच, दिस इज गोना बी एपिसोड 40 ऑफ द डिसकंटेंट पॉडकास्ट। एंड इट हमने शुरू किया था ये, हाँ
मोमेंटस
आई टेल यू व्हाई इट्स मोमेंटस, क्योंकि एक दिस इज देयर इज अ गाय आनंद वर्धन, उसका एक कोट है, एनीथिंग फॉर सम रीजन एवरीथिंग डिविजिबल बाय 5 इन इंडिया इज कॉज फॉर सेलिब्रेशन। बट तो बेसिकली इन द यूजिंग दैट सेम लॉजिक, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉज ऑफ सेलिब्रेशन। हमने शुरू किया था पॉडकास्ट सितंबर, आई थिंक अक्टूबर ऑफ 2017 में, ठीक है, विद द इंटेंशन ऑफ हैविंग अ वीकली पॉडकास्ट। एंड अब तक हमने वो लॉजिक के हिसाब से 1 साल भी कंप्लीट नहीं किया वैसे देखा जाए तो। कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू अस, आई थिंक। ऑल्सो वी पुट आउट, वी वर हम लोग बीच में थोड़े रेगुलर हो गए थे और फिर वापस 3 हफ्ते तक कुछ नहीं आया, तो उसके लिए अपॉलॉजीज। आई हैड अ फीवर एंड आई वॉज सिक, आई एम स्टिल अ लिटिल सिक, बट आई एम बेटर नाउ, तो हम लोग भी कर रहे हैं। भरत वॉज ऑल्सो, भरत इज नाउ, भरत ये मैं काट सकता हूँ देखो चाहिए तो, बट भरत हैज क्विट हिज जॉब नाउ बेसिकली, एंड ही इज नाउ फ्रीलांसर। सो एनीबडी लुकिंग टू गिव प्रोजेक्ट्स, दिस इज लाइक आवर, ट्विटर पे डालते ना हम लोग कि हम लोग को जॉब दे दो, हमें जॉब दे दो, हमें प्लीज, मैं बहुत
हाँ वैसे
टैलेंटेड हूँ,
डालना
मुझे जॉब
पड़ेगा।
दे दो, प्लीज एम्पलीफाई, वैसा टाइप का भरत के लिए ये मेरे तरफ से और ये पॉडकास्ट की तरफ से प्लीज। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट वी आर गोइंग टू बी पुटिंग आउट मोर कॉन्टेंट। भरत हैज मेड अ वीडियो। भरत, डू यू वांट टू टॉक अबाउट इट, डू यू वांट लेट द वीडियो कम आउट? तुझे थोड़ा हाइप करना है या आने देना?
हाइप करता हूँ। तो
तो भरत टेल अस अबाउट
बेसिकली
दैट वीडियो अ लिटिल बिट, जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट।
या बेसिकली व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू ट्राई like to try try to start a video series about Bollywood, and I feel that there are a lot of people out there who are doing video analysis and movie analysis based on international films, but India mein aisa koi hai nahi apart from I think Cinema Beyond Entertainment and Cinema Wali वगैरह, so there are not a lot of people who are doing that currently, and I want to talk in very like I'll talk in very conversational terms, and I will basically take up mainstream Bollywood and try to see if I can analyze those films. So पहला वीडियो आई थिंक आना चाहिए इन अ वीक और सो।
I think by the time this podcast is out, in उसके 1 दिन पहले या 1 दिन बाद ये वो वीडियो भी आ जाना चाहिए। एक्चुअली 1 दिन बाद ही, पहले क्यों आएगा, 1-2 दिन बाद उसके आ जाना चाहिए वीडियो फॉर श्योर। सो प्लीज चेक दैट आउट वेन एवर दैट कम्स आउट, एंड सब्सक्राइब टू अस फॉर मोर स्टफ। सेकेंडली, बिफोर वी गो ऑन टू टूडेज टॉपिक्स, द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप विच वॉज प्रोमिस्ड हैज नॉट येट कम टू फ्रूशन। काफी लोगों के, वैसे मैंने जब भी थोड़ा रो के मैंने बोला था कि यार खाई 3 लोग क्या है रिक्वेस्ट थोड़े भेजो, तो काफी मतलब 20-25 लोग ने भेज दिए, तो हम लोग बनाएंगे व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, थोड़ा टाइम दे दो,
तो
थोड़े से बिजी थे और थोड़ा मूड भी नहीं था वैसे ज्यादा बात करने का लोगों से, तो अब वो मूड बन रहा है आई थिंक वापस, तो वो हम लोग करेंगे शॉर्टली, ठीक है। रूल्स बाय द वे, व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप जब हम बनाएंगे रूल्स होंगे, और वो रूल्स को प्लीज फॉलो कर लेना, प्लीज फालतूगिरी मत करना, कोई पॉलिटिक्स वो सब प्लीज मत लेके आना, ऐसे सर की बात किया तो किक कर जाओगे, ठीक है। तो मूविंग ऑन, टुडेज टॉपिक्स आर द इज द ट्रेलर ऑफ ड्यून बाय डेन डेनी डेनिस डेनी विलेनुवे विलेनुव एंड चैतन्य तमाने की फिल्म जो है डिसाइपल, उसका ट्रेलर, ड्यून का ट्रेलर, और एंड ऑल्सो चैतन्य तमाने इज कोर्ट विच केम वे बैक इन 2015, पर उसकी आई डोंट थिंक हमने कभी प्रॉपरली बात की है, एंड इट्स अ प्रीटी गुड फिल्म। तो आई थिंक ड्यून का पहले बात कर लेते हैं बिकॉज दैट्स फ्रेश, एंड ऑल्सो द अदर टू आर काइंड ऑफ रिलेटेड टू इच अदर, सो देन वी कैन गेट फुली इन टू दैट। तो आई विल जस्ट गिव सम बेसिक दिस थिंग। भरत ओवर हियर हैज रेड ड्यून द बुक, द फर्स्ट वन। हिमांशु एंड आई आर करंटली रीडिंग द बुक। हिमांशु तू कौन से पेज पे है, तेरे को याद है? मतलब
मैं किंडल पे 17% पे हूँ। आई डोंट नो द पेज।
ओके, तो 17%, मैं हूँ 13% पे, विच इज 115 पेजेस, तो तू मेरे से मतलब 20 पेज आगे होगा अप्रोक्सीमेटली। काफी इंटरेस्टिंग, बट सिंस भरत हैज रेड द फुल बुक, बिना स्पॉइलर दिए आई थिंक भरत यू गो फर्स्ट, योर फर्स्ट इम्प्रेशन ऑफ द ट्रेलर।
सो आई I mean, I watched the trailer. I mean, yesterday only, na, at least. Yeah. So, kal maine, kal I saw it like with the like with everybody only, and I think that a lot of people who've not read the book, which is quite a lot right now, were really really excited to watch it and the grand scale that it has been mounted on. And while I agree that wo grand scale bahut sahi lag raha hai, and a lot of visuals actually look very very good. And to be honest, faithful to the book, I feel that there is a certain, like, I can talk about it later also when we're talking about it, but I felt mera first impression tha ki yaar main cautiously optimistic hu for the movie, because obviously Denis Villeneuve is like one of the best filmmakers we have right now, but my only thing is tonally I feel the book requires a little bit more madness than I've seen in his films, and with madness I mean slightly more absurdism, slightly more fantastical, and slightly more fun, for the lack of a better word. With Denis Villeneuve's films, I feel they've all been very serious. Like, I don't, mujhe genuinely yaad nahi hai main kabhi Denis Villeneuve ki film mein kabhi smile bhi kiya hu ki nahi. Mujhe nahi lagta. So, and I'm not saying ki Dune is like a screwball comedy or something, but my point is ki agar kisi ko Lord of the Rings ka tone yaad hai, to wo mujhe bahut preferable hai. Like Percy Jackson keh raha hu, Peter Jackson ka jo style hai ya jo tone hai, wo mujhe, that would have suited Dune the most. Having said all of this, I know and I've read up on this ki Denis Villeneuve has been wanting to make Dune since he was a kid. To uski favorite book hai, and wo kehta hai ki this is not my adaptation of the book, but this is the adaptation of the dreams that I had after I read the book. So I'm guessing,
ट्रेलर वॉज लाइक फक वॉट इज दिस आई नीड टू वॉच दिस नाउ राइट वैसा था एंड आई गॉट सो एक्साइटेड एंड एनी वे बिकॉज ऑन भरत रिकमेंडेशन आई वॉज थिंकिंग ऑफ रीडिंग द बुक तो मैंने ट्रेलर के लिटरली 15 मिनट बाद मैंने बुक खरीदी किंडल पे और मैं रीड कर रहा हूँ और यार मैं 100 पेज पढ़ने का मुझे लग रहा है कि ये आई केम आउट ऑफ द सेम बोट एज भरत आई थिंक विच इज कॉशियसली ऑप्टिमिस्टिक आई स्टिल वॉन्टेड टू बी अ गुड फिल्म बट ऑब्वियसली आई वॉन्ट एवरी फिल्म टू बी अ गुड फिल्म स्पेशली दिस वन आई वॉन्ट टू बी लाइक अ ग्रेट फिल्म बट मुझे बहुत अभी डाउट हो रहा है एंड माई अप्रिहेंशन इज नॉट कमिंग जस्ट फ्रॉम दैट वॉट यू सेड यू नो कि और मेरे दिमाग में भी पीटर जैक्सन आ रहा था बिकॉज पीटर जैक्सन कम्स फ्रॉम वॉट आई लाइक टू कॉल बकचोद सिनेमा ही इज ऑल्सो कम फ्रॉम लाइक इंडी लाइक हिमांशु आई थिंक इज इंट्रोड्यूस मी टू अ लॉट ऑफ पीटर जैक्सन व्हेन वी वर आई रिमेम्बर अ कपल ऑफ इयर्स अगो यू शोड मी सम ऑफ हिज क्रेजी इंडी फिल्म जो ही हैड मेड विच आर लाइक insane uske bare mein Himanshu if you want to talk you can refer to it but my main point of this thing comes from you know while reading the book I am feeling that I've read the first Game of Thrones for example and this I mentioned to you guys privately also so in that and the writing style is very similar in the sense that the worlds are very very similar I find maybe Dune maine pura padha nahi hai to maybe Dune is a lot more complex and a lot more intellectual or whatever it is but I do see that George R. R. Martin has taken a lot of influence from this, I think. Because Niko padhte time to, you know, a lot of, because almost every scene is like a part of something grand, a part of something that will lead to something bigger. And it's a lot of detail and it's a lot, the world is very vast. So my fear is not just that ki wo tonally Denis Villeneuve might not be able to handle it. I think the film form itself is wrong for this kind of story. In the first 100 pages, I can tell that this is not a feature film. This is a series. Easily. Like, I feel like in order to truly do justice to... I felt like the first 100 episodes should be like about 3 hours of... You know, like 3 episodes of 1 hour each. Because
But let me stop you there because... Sure. Denis Villeneuve has said that this is just... The first movie is just half of the book.
Right, so, right.
So I think... I mean, roughly 300 to 350 pages is what.
No, but I know what that. So yeah, for context for our viewers and listeners who have probably not read Dune, द फर्स्ट बुक इटसेल्फ इज डिवाइडेड, वैसे तो 6 बुक है सीरीज में, 800 पेज की बाय द वे पहली बुक, एंड फर्स्ट बुक में देयर इज अ डिवीजन ऑफ बुक 1 एंड बुक 2, एंड द फिल्म का ट्रेलर जो हमने देखा है अभी ड्यून का, दैट अपेरेंटली इज द बुक 1 व्हिच इज द फर्स्ट 350 ऑड पेजेस इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, राइट? सो देयर इज दैट, बट यू नो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, दैट इवन द गेम ऑफ थ्रोन्स का जो फर्स्ट बुक था, that was season 1 of Game of Thrones, so that was 10 hours, okay? So I'm saying that there is a lot of world building that we might lose out on, because it reminds me a lot of Game of Thrones, because there are ruling factions, there are different cults, there are different sort of people who have their own sort of armies, and they have their own intricacies and their culture and religion and everything. So I think it might need a lot more, but obviously देख के पता चलेगा. सो फार आई एम ऑल्सो कॉशियसली ऑप्टिमिस्टिक. हिमांशु, योर व्यूज.
या बिफोर, कैन यू गाइस हियर मी?
या या, कैन यू हियर?
सो बिफोर आई डाइसेक्ट और माय द ट्रेलर और पुट आउट माय व्यूज, आई एक्चुअली वांट टू हाइप अप द मूवी फॉर पीपल हु डोंट नो अबाउट द मूवी, बिकॉज़ आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट नो. आई डोंट थिंक इट्स वेरी वेल नोन लाइक व्हाट दिस बुक इज अबाउट and what is at stake with this particular film. So Denis Villeneuve has made the best movies of the last couple of years, okay, and we have seen his best works and have been really excited for this particular movie, because Dune, this book that came out, when did it come out, Bharat?
1968.
I don't know.
So it's a very old book, yeah. And people have tried to make this into a movie, and a lot of critics have said that it's not possible to make this into a movie. That's the first thing that a lot of people have said, that Dune cannot be made into a movie, and whoever has tried has failed up until now. So the stakes are high, and when the best one of the best directors in the world right now, when he picks up the project and brings in all of these actors, it is a once in a lifetime thing. You have to, you know, get into this, and you can expect really good, a really good film. So if you haven't read the book, this should be the time to read it and buy it and read it. And I have started reading it, and I haven't read a book in a long time, like a fiction. I had read some other things, but I picked it up very scared, because I asked Bharat ki, can I even read it? It's a science fiction, and I tried Asimov and I could not at one point. And Bharat said it's accessible and it's easy. He didn't say it's easy.
Bharat said it's complicated, bro.
It's complicated, yeah.
I said complicated.
Yeah, but after I picked it up, after I picked it up, I could read it. I started reading and I got into the flow. The only thing is, you know, what scares people about science fiction reading is that the names of the places and the planets and whatever, these things are very different, right? And it's very difficult to follow it at times. So yeah, what I started doing is that I started Googling a little bit of anything new that came up about, like any new name. So I just had a basic info in mind, oh, this person is this, this person is this. And then when the trailer dropped and I could connect all the cast with the characters, at that point it became very easy. I think that was really nice. Yeah. You should read it at this point after watching the trailer.
Definitely.
That is my hype.
I think everyone should definitely read the book irrespective. Like, you know, by the way, what Himanshu was referencing, shout out to iPad. Because iPad pe, because I'm reading it on the iPad, if you highlight a word, right, then automatically it'll Wikipedia it, it'll do a dictionary and a Google search. Okay, so I will automatically get all. So mere ko immediately aata.
ये Kindle पे भी होता है. Kindle पे भी same है.
I don't think all versions of Kindle. जो I think जो touchscreen नहीं है उसपे शायद नहीं होता होगा.
नहीं, हाँ उसमें नहीं होता.
हाँ. Harry Potter for example. I read the first part of Harry Potter in 12th standard just to see what the deal is about. That's all. But, you know, I'm starting to get into it more. And I feel like, you know, despite Dune's complexities, I think Dune is a very good starting point for people to get into sci-fi also, like the book. And hopefully the film also. Because, A, it's grown up. Okay. And B, it's a lot of politics and a lot of capitalism sort of economics, and there's a lot of those things which I think older people can appreciate a lot more and look at critically a lot better. Also, like I also feel ki the other thing with the book, but that's why I was saying that people are afraid that it can't be turned into a film. Mujhe abhi lag raha hai ki tum logo ne lagta hai ki series will do a lot better on this.
That's also the suggestion by the previous Dune actor,
Kyle,
the one made by
Kyle,
David Lynch.
Kyle MacLachlan, jo apna Twin Peaks wala.
Yeah. So he said the same thing recently, I think today or yesterday, that I think it is still better suited for a series. Don't make it into a movie. I don't know. I'll have to read the rest of it. But I'll tell you one thing I noticed. The trailer suggests a lot of action, you know. And while reading the book, I found that is a little misleading, because most of the part I've read has very little, science fiction, action, grandeur, or and stuff like that. It's mostly about characters interacting and talking.
See, there are very few moments which, I mean, there are jahan pe tum log ho usse lekar end tak. At least 3-4 aisi jagah hai jahan pe fighting hai, like proper fighting, especially towards the end wo jo ek big climactic top type ka scene hota hai wo hai. So I'm guessing they are going to amplify those scenes and those things, because you know, Hollywood, big budget Hollywood, whatever. Also just to sort of contradict what you guys are saying, I genuinely felt after reading the first book that the first book itself, I have not read the other books, so I don't know that. But jo puri pehli kitab hai na, it reads perfectly as a hero's journey, you know. So, and it has a proper story, beginning, middle, and end. So I, that sort of makes me believe that it might work as a film also. Having said that, yes, there is a lot of complexity that you will need to really go into if you you know, jo shayad ek film ke liye suited now, but as a story, sirf first kitab. एक इंसान की स्टोरी पूरी है एंड इट डिपिक्ट्स इट कंप्लीटली. ऐसा नहीं है कि एंड में कुछ रह गया. सो दैट आई फील लेंड्स इटसेल्फ वेल एनफ टू अ मूवी आल्सो. एंड इफ इट्स अ टू मूवी थिंग लाइक हाउ डेनी विलेन्यूव इज डूइंग, आई थिंक इट काइंड ऑफ मेक्स सेंस. लेट्स सी.
मुझे एक और डर है कि यू नो, व्हेनेवर देयर आर दीस हाइप्ड अप बिग बजट हॉलीवुड मूवीज विद ऑल द बेस्ट एक्टर्स और ऑल द पॉपुलर एक्टर्स इन इट ना, मेरे को वो दोस प्रोजेक्ट्स अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स फॉल फ्लैट वेरी बैडली. ओके, एंड इट्स लाइक दैट होल कॉन्सेप्ट, जैसे फुटबॉल में बोलते हैं ना कि एक टीम में सारे आप बेस्ट स्ट्राइकर लोगे तो क्या ही करोगे, मतलब इन द टीम गेट्स इवन मोर फक्ड, राइट? सो आई फील लाइक देयर इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ दैट का पॉसिबिलिटी आल्सो, दो आई थिंक दैट इज जस्ट सिनिसिज्म आल्सो ऑफ अ सर्टेन लेवल फ्रॉम अस. सो बेसिकली आवर 40 मिनट्स गॉट ओवर इन द लास्ट रिकॉर्डिंग, तो ये वाला थोड़ा सा फ्रेश हो जाएगा अभी, ठीक है? प्लीज गाली मत देना, जूम खाली 40 मिनट अलाउड करते हैं हम लोग को, हमने पैसे नहीं देने हम लोगों को. तो ओके, सो वेयर वी एट, वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट ड्यून, वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट बीइंग अ सीरीज, एंड भारत वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ इट कुड वर्क बेस्ड ऑन हिज रीडिंग ऑफ द बुक. एंड आई जस्ट वांट टू मेंशन वन मोर थिंग अबाउट दिस थिंग, दैट यू नो दैट इट्स अप्रोचेबल, आई फील लाइक इट्स एन अप्रोचेबल साइफाई बुक दैट पीपल शुड रीड. ऑल्सो इट्स अनदर थिंग दैट यू नो, पीपल हु मेक अ फिल्म, एंड आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ अस एज फिल्म मेकर्स ऑल्सो will admit that you can never truly expect, and I always find that thing a little weird when people are like, oh, this movie wasn't like the book, or it wasn't as good as the book. It's never going to be the same. It's a different grammar, it's a different medium. So you can never truly, it's just about being the best adaptation and the most ideal one, right, that you can find in that balance. Like, I hope that Denis Villeneuve does bring a lot of himself into it, because I mean, as we all know, he's a pretty great filmmaker. So his filmmaking is not at stake over here. I'm pretty sure that is not. So yeah. I just hope he brings in his own. If he can't do justice to the book that way, I really hope he brings in himself into it. That would be my hope. for it. You know, I don't want him to even be completely accurate or completely faithful to the book.
I also want to sort of recommend a movie. I don't know if you guys have watched it, but I watched it in the lead up to the trailer, which is basically how Jodorowsky failed to make, failed to make Dune, right? It's called Jodorowsky's Dune. And it's really, really, like, really fun documentary on some, on a movie that I feel would have been the best version of Dune. So, yeah.
Why couldn't Jodorowsky and make it,
I'd recommend you guys to... अरे यार बहुत सारे इश्यूज थे क्योंकि एक तो वो एकदम प्रॉपर आउटडोर जो भी होता है आउटडोर प्रॉब्लम था कि ओवर बजट हो गया बहुत बड़ी मतलब टू बिग टू बी ट्रू शॉट्स एंड ही आल्सो हैड लाइक उसने पिंक फ्लॉयड का म्यूजिक इमेजिन किया था उसमें एंड ही इमेजिन्ड ऑल ऑफ दीस थिंग्स
व्हिच दे यूज्ड इन द ट्रेलर ना
द फैक्ट दैट
या
व्हिच दे यूज्ड
एज अ थ्रोबैक टू हिज जोडोरोव्स्की
या इफ यू गाइस हैव वॉच Jodorowsky. I have actually watched because I don't know why actually. I have no idea. So, uski do film hai, tum log please dekho. One is called The Holy Mountain and the other is called El Topo. And both, and he was basically, matlab David Lynch, agar tum log samaj, David Lynch, agar 10 out of 100 in surrealism hai, to wo banda 100 tak pahunch chuka hai. Theek hai? So, and it's like some other level of surrealism. So I just hope, I mean I wish that you know, he would have completed the film because wo ek surreal level pe le jata Dune ko.
Abhi bhi zinda hai na, kuch 90 saal ka hai na Jodorowsky.
90 saal ka.
Surreal bhi jaate hain kafi time tak, I feel. Somehow.
Maine David Lynch ka Dune thoda sa dekha. I didn't see the whole thing because I didn't want spoilers. So I just watched like till where I read because I wanted to see a little bit. And I found it to be good there. I liked it. I found it like, I think he took a funny approach only. He made it fun. It's like Star Wars, but stupid Star Wars. You know, he didn't put the seriousness in it. But I liked it. Have you guys tried to watch it? It's damn funny. Stupid.
I'm a big David Lynch fan, but I remember in college when I was on my David Lynch binge, I was told and I like... told मतलब on the I read a lot about it on the internet कि ये movie मत देखो बहुत ही फालतू किया है इसने बहुत ही गंदा movie है mood खराब है मत देखो तो मैं नहीं देखा था
he's taking the source material very lightly मतलब he's making fun of the book is what I feel
that's a good I mean according to me that's a good approach because I don't know it's a very Lynchian thing to do also
yeah it's also a very filmmaker fuck you thing to do no to an author usually ki main apna karega tu dekh le theek hai matlab aisa type ka approach I think Dune safe to say despite all our apprehensions about it I think we are very excited
yeah
it is definitely promising Jason Momoa I think usko kafi ruin karne ki koshish karega I hope uska damage control ho jaye but let's see beyond how that goes Timothy Chalamet Zendaya jo bhi ye log hain आजकल के सस्ते लियोनार्डो डिकैप्रियो तो फिर आई होप कि मूवी अच्छी निकले लेट्स टॉक अबाउट नाउ लेट्स गो टू इफ यू गाइस अनलेस यू गाइस वांट टू से एनीथिंग ऑन ड्यून एनीथिंग
एल्स
ओके सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द ट्रेलर ऑफ द डिसाइपल बाय चैतन्य थमाने आई होप द ऑडियंस हैज सीन द ट्रेलर ऑफ दिस फिल्म I'll just give my opinion first and then Himanshu you can take it forward from there I thought after watching that trailer that this is like more indie and more serious and more cerebral and basically all in all like the BAP of Whiplash okay like a very slow moving Whiplash because it's about Indian classical so it's got to be more cerebral it's got to be more of this so and I personally thought that given the cred that Tamane has built from court I really cannot wait I feel like at some level I'm way more excited for the disciple than I am for Dune simple reason being that I don't know the last time I was this excited for an Indian filmmaker, especially someone जिसने पहली movie में फोड़ दिया और second movie भी Venice जाके आ रही है, तो and looks very very promising. Plus he did the entire mentorship under Cuarón, so I am super excited for Disciple, and I think its trailer to me looked perfect, man. Like I really did not think what else I could want from it. Himanshu.
Yeah. So for the people who haven't seen the trailer or don't know anything about Chaitanya and his work, I think we should just talk about it for 1 second, right?
Mm.
So this guy, he made a film called Port a couple of years back, which got the National Film Award for the best movie and a couple of other really promising awards outside.
Oscar run bhi karne ki koshish ki thi, which I thought it should have gotten, frankly.
Yeah, but but I think some Ayushman Khurrana movie or something. Ranveer Singh ka Padmavat or something went.
No. Court only went. Court had gone. They did not select it. But Court had gotten through the first round. Court had gone through the first round. Second round, where final selection hota, wahan pe nahi hua. So
the executive producer is Alfonso Cuarón, who is the director of Gravity. And Chaitanya went and worked under him for a long time. And that is how this film came about, which is a big deal. And also, this film went to Toronto Film Festival, right?
TIFF.
Yeah, TIFF. And TIFF is apparently like Indian movies don't go there.
नहीं भाई क्या बोल रहा है? TIFF में सब जाती है. TIFF में तो ये भी गई थी कोंकणा सेन शर्मा की फिल्म गई थी कि TIFF में सब जो जाते हैं. नहीं भाई, so the thing is the achievement for Disciple has been that by the way, even Court won best debut at Venice, but in Europe the top three film festivals are considered to be Cannes, Berlinale and Venice, and after 20 years that an Indian film has gone to one of the top three European film festival in their official main category of and Gunnar's official selection. The last one was Meera Nair's Monsoon Wedding, which I love. But yeah, so there's a lot of hype also. But tujhe kya laga trailer ke bare mein, apart from the context and all that, what did you think of it personally?
I like the feel of it. I think I have started appreciating movies more which are not cut to the beat, because I have also been doing that for a long time now. So I have seen The Hack. So it is, I appreciated it. I think it was like very meditative, very calming. But I have a feeling that the film is not going to be like that. I think the film is going to be intense. Just the trailer has been made to look like it's going to be chill. Actually, it's not going to be. I think the trailer is also a bit hardcore only. What do you think, Bharat?
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I completely agree. I felt that, मतलब ऐसा होता है ना जो थोड़ा कुछ अच्छी कहानी आराम से बताने वाले हैं. It was exactly like a build-up to, you know, a concert, like a Hindustani classical concert ka beginning. So I completely echo with both of your thoughts. I am genuinely looking forward to it more than, let's say, Dune. Because ek essentially Indian film lag rahi hai. And Chaitanya Tamane ka, main bahut baar bhool jata hu ki Court is not a Hindi film. It's a Marathi film.
No, and it's actually, I would say it's a multilingual film, which is very, somehow, I don't know why we don't make more multilingual films. Anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Hmm. And that's why I feel, and without sort of, like usually award-winning regional films are a certain way, you know, they talk about a certain thing a certain way. They thoda sa ek pity generate karte hain, thoda sa ek, you know, pathos generate karte hain. But with Chaitanya, Court was very almost cold. Like it wasn't, it was almost not emotional only. And yet it got its point across very, very strongly, right? And that way, I think Chaitanya Tamane, I personally respect that guy. And I think he was 28 or something when he made Court. So he's also younger, maybe, yeah. So my point is that he has that knack of knowing his reality and sticking to it, pandering to both the kind of, you know, one is the art, you know, art film types, and the other is this, you know, other like melodramatic or whatever kind you might want to call it. I think he's good at his own truth.
Yeah, I would just like to add something because I recently watched an interview of Chetan Adamane, and I'm just putting this out there in the universe. If there's anybody I want to get on this podcast to talk about their films with Chetan Adamane, because I really respect this filmmaker. Okay, so I mean, and just off the basis of one film, which I thought was world class, and everybody, I mean, if Cuarón thought it was world class, so matlab kya hai? So, you know, and I find that this guy, the reason I'm so fond of him, because he's like a true auteur. And especially with this second film trailer, I'm realizing that about him. You know, like he likes to grasp reality in its rawest, true, as Bharat said, truth, you know. And he's done that in Court with, as you, I really like that use of the word cold, you know, because in Court he does use it in a, it's a very cold reality. It's a very unflinching, unimposing reality, you know, like even a simple scene like in Court, and this is a bit, not a spoiler because I don't think you can spoil a film like Court, but that scene where that lawyer is going with the widow of the manhole cleaner, you know, just the way that she is sitting in that front seat.
Yeah.
And it's just the conversation that they're having is not even a conversation. It's just like, oh, where should I drop you? But even in that, there is a reality that he has shown clearly. You know, that happens, I think, towards the end of the film. And the interview I was talking about, there was an interview with Anupama Chopra, which I was going to put in my recommendation of this episode, but I guess that's what it is. Usme, he said that Court, he was apparently 24 or something, 23 or 24, where Vivek Gomber, who was the lead actor in Court, the lead actor as in the lawyer, a human rights lawyer in Court. And he basically used to, he had pitched him this idea after. So by the way, Chetan Adamane started working in the television industry as a writer at the age of 17. Okay. He was writing for TV at the age of 17, like K serials types. Usne pata kya likha tha? Usne kya hoga Nimmo ka? Usne likha hai. Theek hai. So what a fucking jump, first of all.
Yeah.
Okay. So he went from there, and he was apparently damn depressed around the age of 23-24. And in that interview, he says, and I'm quoting him, otherwise I wouldn't say it, but he says that he was at the stage of giving up his life. Where he was that depressed. He was like, kuch nahi hone wala, kuch nahi hone wala, and he wanted to just end it. And he said he was at a point where he wanted his friends to sort of, like his friends would take turns calling him or checking up on him, ki matlab zinda hai ki nahi, waisa types. And at that moment, he thought of a courtroom drama after going to a sessions court in Bombay and seeing how things are played out. And he just sort of replicated that process, and he told this guy Vivek Gomber, who's also a producer and an actor, that, and he had worked with him on some play before. So usko usne bola ki mujhe likhna hai, and that guy agreed and said ki I'll pay you 15,000 rupees for your sustenance every month, and you write this film, okay, and I'll produce it. So that's how Court got made, and it ended up being this like insanely path-breaking, truly path-breaking. I don't think you can say that for a lot of films, but like. And like, yeah, there's so much to talk about Court also, you know. I mean, do you guys have anything specific? Because I can keep going on, and I don't want to keep going on. So,
I remember watching two films, which was in a quick succession. I think the same year or something. One was Court, and the other was Shahid, right? Hmm. And I sort of really, really like both films. In fact, I like Shahid more for different reasons, which is that Shahid is also very, do you guys remember Shahid?
Of course, yeah.
Yeah.
I felt that also was very, very, I think that was also the resurgence of Hansal Mehta, because uske pehle wo kuch to wo bana raha tha, kya naam hai uska, K serial nahi keh raha hu.
Romantic comedies.
I forget. नहीं संजय गुप्ता के लिए घटिया सी फिल्म बना रहा था याद नहीं आ रही मुझे बट एक बट माय पॉइंट इज दैट ही वाज आल्सो नॉट डूइंग वेल फॉर हिमसेल्फ एंड देन ही मेड शाहिद व्हिच वाज सडनली लाइक व्हाट द फक दिस इज अमेजिंग राइट एंड आई फेल्ट बोथ फिल्म्स हैड दैट रॉनेस एंड शाहिद हैड अ बिट मोर ऑफ नैरेटिव यू नो इट हैड मोर ऑफ अ स्टोरी इट हैड मोर ऑफ अ कैरेक्टराइजेशन कोर्ट वाज जस्ट बेयर You know, it was just almost like reality as it is. You know, it was almost documentary like that way. So, yeah, I mean, that's all I sort of have to say about this.
Good. Himanshu, you have anything? I think I like this movie a lot more than the two of you. Because I have a lot of things to say about it.
In fact, I think you should talk about it. Honestly.
No, you say it. If you have something to add about it.
I saw it in 2014. It's been six years. I think we should talk about it.
So yeah. This is, if those who are listening to audio can't see this, but this is basically, abe yaar, mera background.
The video also can't see it.
I have the DVD. Oh, yeah, now you can see it. So yeah. I have the DVD of Court, and it's one of maybe like five or six films jiska DVD I've bothered to buy in this digital time. And मुझे याद है मैं गया था क्रॉसवर्ड जाके मैंने खरीदी थी आई वेंट आउट ऑफ द सिंगुलर वापस निकला घर से मैंने डीवीडी खरीदी बिकॉज आई लव्ड द आई हैव सीन इट लाइक एटलीस्ट 8-10 टाइम्स ओके एंड आई थिंक यू नो इट लाइक द फिल्म इज लाइक द टू मी इट्स द बेस्ट पोर्ट्रेयल ऑफ अर्बन इंडिया दैट हैज बीन शोन बाय एनीबॉडी इन माय ओपिनियन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द कास्ट एंगल ऑफ इट क्लास एंगल ऑफ इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ we deal with the state, how the state deals with us, what is bureaucracy really like, you know, and the film is painstakingly slow. And I really feel that the reason for that is not just some artiness, you know, because a lot of films I also tend to dismiss because they are too slow for no reason. Okay. There's no reason for that pace, but this film earns its pace, because Indian courtrooms are slow as shit. Right, they take so long, and I feel like when you're in that court listening to a lawyer drone on about some baseless bullshit technicality that has no place in the real world for 10 minutes at a stretch and the shot does not cut, I feel like you feel like you're in that courtroom, and you feel like you're going through that shit system of everything that works there the way it does.
Yeah.
Right, and to me it is such a non-judgmental film. I've never seen a film that talks about so many social issues, but still remains to be completely non-judgmental. It doesn't judge the human rights lawyer, for example, for, say, going for a spa after having his face blackened for something dumb he said, something insulting he said about some community in court, right? He, like, you know, there's a scene where uska face kala kar dete hain, and next shot you see him, he's in a spa, you know, which is And it's funny in the first instance, but then you realize this is the reality this dude comes from. He shops in that supermarket where this person is, you know, this human rights lawyer is sort of shopping in this expensive place. And then we cut to the other lawyer, the government prosecutor, who's like this right-wing woman who has like really parochial whatever thoughts, right? And she is talking in the train about how expensive olive oil is for a while. You know, and I feel like that also is also about, it tells you that things are not so black and white in this world, you know, things are, like they're going to, when you see this cute family going for a play to watch a play, they're just a cute family. And then you see them watch what play they're watching, which is like a ultra right wing play about kicking out, immigrants, right?
Yeah.
Then you realize, okay, it's a little, this thing with the casualness with which that public prosecutor says, you know, ki Marathi mein wo bolte hai, aur main Hindi mein bolta hu ki 20 saal ke liye daal ke khatam karo, kya karna hai? You know, like over a abetment to suicide, over a bullshit case, and she says it so casually. And I just feel like so many nuances of Indian life it captures so perfectly, you know.
Also to add on to that, now that I remember more of it, I've also seen it, I think, more. As Manshu said, back when it released, so I don't know. I've not had a second viewing. But I also remember that what I went back home was with the one word, if I had to describe the movie with, would be context.
Okay?
So there is court and the happenings in court, and then you follow each of the characters in the court and see the context of what they're saying, why they're saying that, and where they come from. Right? Literally, like, I know where you come from, where you're coming from, but I disagree with you, whatever. So that this is the cinematic equivalent of, I know where you're coming from. And yeah, so that's it. I felt that was my, you know, the one thing I left the movie with. So yeah.
Yeah, that is a very good point, because the film does, that's what it does, right? It gives context to people we've otherwise seen on screen, or otherwise, we've seen the revolutionary person. We've seen the revolutionary person being oppressed by the state and the evil public prosecutor. We've seen the righteous lawyer. We've seen all these people, but not with context. And that's what I feel like anyone watching this film will understand. Anyone from outside watching this film will understand India very well. Like, I remember on our podcast with Jaideep Verma, we were talking about how, you know, a film's value to your country is only when you can show it to people outside your country and they will understand what your country is all about. Right? And I feel like Court is one of those that they will get a very intrinsic part of India somehow. You know, like, people are not completely one way or the other. It's a lot of things meshing together. Basically, yeah. I can keep going on about this movie, but I think we've had a pretty good chat. Unless you guys have something more to add, Himanshu.
Do you find similarities between Court and like Ship of Thesis or something? Do you guys think that it came out around the same time, right?
Yeah. I mean, it came out, I think, a couple of years before. 2013 Ship of Thesis, 2015 Court. I remember. I think.
2014 Court. I think that was the time when we started watching good films. So that is why Court has such a huge impact on
speak for yourself, Himanshu.
I know. Ship of Thesis is not considered.
But meko nahi lagta, I don't think Ship of Thesis is I personally don't think they're comparable exactly. I think Ship of Thesis is still like an outsider's view of India. Court is, I feel, a lot more rooted, for a lack of a better term. But Bharat, you were not.
Yeah, right.
You agree with Himanshu?
No, I agree. I agree with you. No, who said? Oh yeah, Himanshu said that it's similar, right? Because I felt the look of the movie is similar, the way it's shot, and like a color pattern or the way people have been shot, which is like, oh, you just go ahead and act. We'll shoot you for 10 minutes. That kind of
thing. Yeah.
By the way, this is not shot like that. The disciple is not shot like Court. I think there is some drama to be expected from the disciple.
Perhaps.
But it's shot like a very aesthetic and a cinematic film. It looks very beautiful.
I thought even Court was shot very... Actually, no, Court was kept very real also. Also, the other thing with Ship of Thesis and Court, ka meko main difference hota hai. Ship of Thesis, mein, there is a very clear philosophical bent that the director is trying to take and trying to sell. There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, that's a personal choice of the filmmaker. I don't think Chaitanya Tamane is trying to sell you on one side or one way of thinking or another way of thinking or something like that. I think Chaitanya Tamane is just trying to very cliched, but like show you a mirror of what happens in your country. You know, but it's actually a mirror, because if I was to just put a... I feel like if one of us was to go to a court and they were to allow us to put a camera, I feel like that's how things would happen. I've not been to a court, but I feel like this is the... If I... Whatever experience I have with a government office, whether it's a driving license, police station, whatever it is, I feel like that's how things actually play out, rather than how we're used to thinking. Right? So, I think that should be enough for today. Unless, again, you guys have something to add.
Can we do recommendations?
Yeah. Go ahead. I already recommended my thing, which is that Chaitanya Tamane interview with Anupama Chopra. I think it came out a few months ago. It's on Film Companion. So, I'll link it on YouTube in the description. Check it out, Bharat. And read, read Dune. Read Dune for sure. Yeah.
Okay. Himanshu, do you want to go before me? Because I'm still thinking. I had something, but I'm still thinking.
Yaar, Bharat, tu soch le aaram se.
Achha, maine soch liya actually. I was talking to Aditya only about this only. So there's this less famous page on YouTube called Cinema Wali. And she basically does Bollywood analysis. And she really goes deep in the sense that her videos are... On an average, I'm guessing 10 to 15 minutes long. And she really delves into what she's saying. So she's done a very interesting analysis of Choked, where she's basically made the argument that each of the characters stands for a Modi, then another character stands for the RBI, and another character stands for India. So that's a level of analysis that she does. And one of my personal favorite videos that I think we should link also in the description is a video essay on how Irfan Khan uses body language in The Namesake to depict different time zones, timelines, in the sense when he's younger,
time period, when he's older. Yeah,
time periods, and he's playing this Bengali uncle. So definitely watch that. Yeah.
All right, we'll link Cinema Wali's channel. It's a YouTube channel, right?
Yeah.
So we'll link that YouTube channel also in the description. Himanshu, go ahead.
So it's not a recommendation of any channel or something, but I would say that suppose you want to get into Dune, right? And now is the time, right? So what you can do is you can YouTube videos on Dune. And what is happening is I've been doing it for some days now. And what I figured out is it's people have made hundreds and hundreds of videos just explaining what the universe is about. And the universe and all the six books combined, they span over 34,000 years, okay? So it's a very big story. So you can take your time with the whole universe, you know? You can go around and watch a lot of videos and figure it out yourself. It's quite fun. That's what I have been doing. So I'll just, that's it. I think that's a recommendation.
Just adding on to what Himanshu said, there is actually a YouTube channel called Secrets of Dune.
Yeah.
Which I personally have been referring to. And it has a lot of content, like a lot. So, yeah.
All
right. So to wrap up, today's recommendations were read Dune, watch Chaitanya Damani's interview with Anupama Chopra on Film Companion, Cinema Wali's YouTube channel, and her Irfan Khan video especially. And Himanshu, you said YouTube channels which talk about Dune, like Secrets of Dune, which we'll also link on the YouTube description. So if you're on SoundCloud or Spotify, come to YouTube and check it out, and also subscribe while you're here. I think it's been a pretty fun episode. So yeah, thanks for listening and watching, guys, and bye-bye.
Bye.